مثل رائدة الفضاء التي تابعناها قبل قليل شونا بانديا، السيدة باسوتي جيرتي بولو هي أيضا تحلق بأفكارها في الفضاء، لها دور ريادي في حث النساء على الولوج للعلوم، لكل العلوم. رئيسة التعليم التكنولوجي بجامعة إفريقيا زيمبابوي لها كلمة تتشاركها معنا.
Good evening, everyone. It is a great honor to be invited to this big event, and I would like to congratulate ESCO for setting up this program on women empowerment. And to all women, I can say you are the reason why we are gathering here today, and also why I lift up my voice. It's only that you are so special. Women are the pillar of this nation. And if you look at the UNESCO statistic report for 2012, you'll see that there are more than women in the world. But if you look at the statistic report, if more women if there are more women than males in this world, so this means that women need to be empowered. Because if you cannot empower women, the world, or we can't do much. So that's why there's a reason why the women need to be empowered. And I also like to congratulate ESCO to launch this program on women empowerment, because of the statistics that we are always seeing that is currently featuring in our daily basis. And also, women, they have the capability and they have the capability to do any job that they want to do. As long as they have the passion, as long as they have the passion and the will to do the certain jobs. So I am a living testimony, because when I grew up, when I was 8 years old, I wanted to be an astronaut. But for me, to be an astronaut is the time that I saw an article about Yuri Gagarin, the man who started going to the moon. Then after reading that that article, I also vowed that even me one day, I want to go to the moon. As long as a human being has tried, I would like to try. But at that time, I was 8 years old, but that thing, it grew up in my mind, in my system. Then later on, I developed a passion to do space science, space applications, and so on. So this is the time that after finishing my O level, at that time, because we were still using the letter application, doing manual application through postal addresses. At that time, I wanted to do a piloting at that time, because I could see that with astronomy was way less that, because I don't have money. So it's better for me maybe to do something that is similar, like a piloting. So I tried to apply for piloting, but still I failed to get the reply. Though I passed very well, because at my primary level and tertiary level, I used to be one of the best students in mathematics and sciences. So my passion was to do something that is not something that is unique, and something that I would enjoy much. So that's when I started to develop a passion on the space science. But at the end of it, I managed to apply for my first degree in geographical information systems, and also I did a postgraduate diploma in space and atmospheric science. That's where I started to do space. So on the work, as I was working on the Ministry of Agriculture of Botswana, where I was applying space application in agriculture, natural resources, and water, and so on. But at that time, I was still raising my kids. And after raising my kids, because I only had only a first degree, then when my kids are grown up, that's when I started again to do my my master's degree, and now I'm about to graduate my PhD after raising the kids. So my journey to space or to this career was long. And also, after doing that, I was now seeing that I was confident that I could even share my experiences, share knowledge that I have with other people global, like the United Nations and so on. When the United Nations launched the Space for Women program, I was one of the experts that attended that program, and also I became a network mentor for NUSA Space for Women program. And later on, that's when I started to be employed by the Africa University in Zimbabwe as an endowed chair, educational technologies, to share with them or to advise them on the advanced technologies that are used to manage resources that are used in education, like online education, where now the Africa University is one of the universities in Zimbabwe that is specializing on online programs or online education. So during this pandemic of COVID, we didn't have any challenge much because we were used to online programs. So our students will continue with online programs, and we managed because of that. But if you look at the background and look at the history of what it's doing, I'm one of the female is one of the advisors or the educational technological advisors. So imagine there was no women, imagine there was nothing like that, so we won't even do much. So looking at the history, like my history and my background, I faced the challenges of support, of the financial support, sponsorship and scholarship, because some sponsorship were like, the sponsorship were only like maybe for male students, because looking at the program that had been offered. Some sponsorship were being based on the age limit, like youth, it would be less than 35 years, but you find that you are more than 35 years and you still want to do the program, you still want to share your ideas, you still want to maybe to find solution of solving solution in our world. So that's where the challenge was. So, but looking at the challenges, I managed to now to do online free programs, to liaise with others and so on. And also to be strong and focus on what I wanted to achieve till today. So what I can say to all women, I can say, never give up. Whatever you dream at that age or at that youth or childhood, make sure that you do it. And follow your dreams, don't follow other people's dreams. Follow your dreams and you must have your own passion, because if you have your own passion, you will never fail. And also, working in a team spirit is very important. Sharing ideas, asking from other colleagues, learning from colleagues, learning from your juniors, learning from your bosses is also important, and you have to work as a team to achieve. And also, the other thing that I can say, that we must encourage each other. We must encourage each other and live as a testimony or live as an example to assist the others. And I can say that a woman should not have any borders around you. Don't border yourself that I'm from African region, I can't do anything from another region, or I'm from this country, I can't do anything. Let us break all the boundaries, break the borders. And also, if you have an idea, if you have a solution to another country, just go there, write to them and solve challenges and so on. So that's why you see we are here, we are from all regions, and we are speaking one word of a woman. And I can say that women also, you find that they are doing a challenging activities, because you find that women are also working at home, you take care of children, and also they must be given time. You must be given time to do all the jobs, you must be supported financially, scholarships, and so on. And also, I can say that women need also the mentorship. Like, you must have a mentor, somebody who went through any problem that you want to do, and so on. And also, as women, you must also be the we must also be the leaders of the leaders that guides youth, like our children and also these young girls. Because if we leave them behind, they can't learn anything. We have to encourage them because they are our tomorrow's as leaders. And I can say that I'm proud to be a woman because I've seen that a woman is very important. I'm here because I'm important. If I was not important, I wouldn't be here. All women who are here, all women who are in the world, somewhere else, whatever they are doing, whether they are doing a job that is not like maybe a digital or linked to these conferences, they are so special because they are there for other people. So that's what I can share with you today, that women are very important and they need all the support from also our leaders, from also the men. If there is a head, that if there's an organization that deals or that is deals with most of the males, they must support women, and all male leaders must support women. Thank you very much. That's what I can share with you for now. Thank you.